In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Fr Eustace Siame A, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
It is Sunday, the 8th of October 2023, 27th Sunday in ordinary time. Do you want to know who you are in this world? The Word of God is reminding us that we are just tenants. We are tenants. We didn't come with anything in this world. We found everything in this world. And our work is to take care that which God entrusted to us. Participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members. Natasha Kaisala Chansa, celebrating her birthday today from Chingola, Zambia, takes for us the first reading. Jose Andrade from Windhoek, Namibia, celebrating his birthday today, takes for us the responsorial psalm. Henry Makumbi, who celebrated his birthday yesterday from Abu Dhabi, United Arab Emirates, takes for us the second reading. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Joseph Kanyu from Bungoma Diocese in Kenya. We also pray for the following Daily Bread members who are celebrating their birthdays. Nakutenda Mainditsa from Gweru, Zimbabwe. Kolisa Munsaka from Victoria Falls, Zimbabwe. And Reina Kusogbo from Luton, United Kingdom. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpass the merits and the desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us to pardon what conscience dreads and to give what prayer does not dare to ask. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
First reading. The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel. A reading from the book of Isaiah. Isaiah 5 verses 1 to 7. Let me sing for my beloved a song concerning his vineyard. My beloved had a vineyard on a very fertile hill. He dug it and cleared it of stones and planted it with choice vines. He built a watchtower in the midst of it and hewed out a wine vat in it. And he looked for it to yield grapes, but it yielded wild grapes. And now, O inhabitants of Jerusalem and men of Judah, judge, I beg you, between me and my vineyard. What more was there to do for my vineyard that I have not done in it? When I looked for it to yield grapes, why did it yield wild grapes? And now I will tell you what I will do to my vineyard. I will remove its hedge and it shall be devoured. I will break down its wall and it shall be trampled down. I will make it a waste. It shall not be pruned or hoed, and briars and thorns shall grow up. I will also command the clouds that they rain no rain upon it. For the vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel, and the men of Judah are pleasant planting. And he looked for justice, but behold, bloodshed. For righteousness, but behold, a cry. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Psalm chapter 80, verse 8 and 11, 12 to 13, 14 to 15 and 17b, 18 to 19. Response is taken from Isaiah chapter 5, verse 7a, And the response is, the vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel.
The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel.
The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel. The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel.
You brought a vine out of Egypt. You drove out the nations and planted it. It stretched out its branches to the sea. To the river it stretched out its shoots.
The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel. The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel.
Then why have you broken down its walls? It is plucked by all who pass by the way. It is ravaged by the boar of the forest, devoured by the beasts of the field.
The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel. The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel.
God of hosts, turn again, we implore. Look down from heaven and see. Visit this vine and protect it, the vine your right hand has planted, the Son of Man you have claimed for yourself.
The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel. The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel.
And we shall never forsake you again. Give us life that we may call upon your name. O Lord, God of hosts, bring us back. Let your face shine forth, and we shall be saved.
The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel. The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel.
The second reading. This do and the God of peace will be with you. A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Philippians. Philippians chapter 4, verse 6 to 9. Brethren, have no anxiety about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, will keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brethren, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. What you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, do. And the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Gospel Acclamation, taken from John chapter 15, verse 16. Hallelujah, 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 amen. Hallelujah, 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 amen. I choose you from the world that you should go and bear fruit, and that your fruit should abide, says the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 amen. Hallelujah, 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 amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Matthew chapter 21, verse 33 to 43. At that time, Jesus said to the chief priests and elders of the people, "Hear another parable. There was a householder who planted a vineyard and set a hedge around it, and dug a winepress in it, and built a tower, and leased it to tenants, and went into another country. When the season of fruit drew near, he sent his servants to the tenants to get his fruit. And the tenants took his servants and beat one, killed another, and stoned another. Again he sent other servants, more than the first, and they did the same to them. Afterwards, he sent his son to them, saying, 'They will respect my son.' But when the tenants saw the son, they said to themselves, 'This is the heir. Come, let us kill him and have his inheritance.' And they took him and cast him out of the vineyard and killed him. When therefore the owner of the vineyard comes, what will he do to those tenants?" They said to him, "He will put those wretches to a miserable den, and lease the vineyard to other tenants who will give him the fruits in their seasons." Jesus said to them, "Have you never read in the scriptures, 'The very stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. This was the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes.' Therefore I tell you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a nation producing the fruits of it." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
What we have listened to in the first reading of today is a love story. The love story between humanity and the chosen race, Israel. It is the parable of the vineyard that is written by Isaiah original, meaning somewhere in the 8th century BC. The people of Israel had been rescued by God from Egypt and brought in the promised land in Canaan, and God made sure that the land was prepared. He made sure that the stones were removed from the vineyard. Remember, it is a desert area and there are so many stones. So the stones were removed so that the vineyard could be prepared very well, and those stones were the inhabitants of the land before the people of God came. They were removed. So all those pagans were removed from the land, and the people of Israel found a place they could stay. That is Palestine. But despite the efforts made by God to make sure that the vines grow in the vineyard, with everything well prepared, not very good results were obtained. Yes, the fruits were produced, but not good fruits. Sour grapes came out. And we hear this in the first reading. "O inhabitants of Israel and men of Judah, judge, I beg you, between me and my vineyard. What more was there to do for my vineyard? Why did it yield sour grapes? I did everything to nurture you, my people, but how come your character, your behavior changed and there was no justice among you, there was no goodness among you, there was everything but good? And so, I suppose God, who was boasting about Israel, now could not boast anymore. God, who was saying, Israel is my beloved, could not boast anymore. And from that time, whenever the devil would ask God, is Israel your child? God would just answer, imagine. Imagine, that's my child. And I suppose God is answering the same to us. We came into this world and we found everything in place. We found God had removed the stones. We were born and we found the world prepared for us. And that world, I'm telling you, my brother, was not a place for people to just stay. No, it was a place for people to bear fruit. It was a place for people to become different. You came into this world not to just enjoy being here. No, God has done too much for you, my brother, too much for you, my sister, to just waste yourself and become a sour grape. With so many sour grapes, God gives you marriage. He makes sure you have a family and you start destroying that family. You become a sour grape. He says, I did everything for you. I removed the stones. Whatever was hindering you from having that marriage, I removed. And you got that marriage. Now you are destroying it. You are destroying it by your unfaithfulness. You are destroying it by your carelessness. You are destroying it by your lack of sympathy for your spouse. You are becoming sour grape. And you are making God not to be proud of you before Lucifer. You are making Lucifer to be very happy, telling God, you see, that's a man. That's a woman you spent your time on to prepare the vineyard in which he is. And look at what is coming out. Unfaithfulness. Look at what is coming out. Drunkenness. Look at what is coming out. Irresponsibility. That's what we have. No. I know there are others who are making God proud because they are bearing very sweet grapes. I have seen that in your commitment, my brother. I have seen that in your commitment, my sister. I have seen it in the way you dedicate your life to your family. I have seen it in the way your children are so proud of you. I have seen it in the way you wake up every morning trying to make sure you do things right. I have seen it. And I know you are making God proud because that's exactly what he wants from us. In the first reading, we hear that God is going to destroy that vineyard. He will remove the fence, meaning the protection that he has granted to each one of us, because we are careless and our vineyard will be invaded. Our marriage will be invaded. Our workplace will be invaded because we are careless. We are dishonest at our workplaces. We are not doing anything to change our environment. He will remove the fence and then we will be invaded by the Babylonians and the Assyrians of our time. We'll be invaded by those cunning men and women who know that we are wasting things. You know, look at your marriage. Do you think everyone is happy that you are married? No, not everyone is happy. There are Babylonians and Assyrians waiting outside to destroy as long as you leave a door open. Do you think everyone is happy with the job that you have? If you don't work diligently, If you don't produce the sweet grapes that are expected of you, you are leaving holes in the wall, and you are going to allow the invaders to come into your system, and you will come and cry and say, what happened to my job? What happened to your job is that you didn't safeguard it by your faithfulness, by your truthfulness. And that's exactly what the gospel passage is telling us today. The parable in the gospel passage of today is modeled on the first reading that we had from Isaiah, where we see the Lord talking about the tenants. Now we have tenants here. The vines become the tenants. The vines in the first reading of today, where the people of Israel become the tenants in the gospel passage of today. That we are the tenants. God has prepared the vineyard. He has prepared everything. And when we start now using our selfishness, when we start now looking for ways of gaining in whatever life God entrusts to us, we will be replaced. Oh, yes. The vineyard is not going to be destroyed as in the first reading of today. No, the vineyard will be kept. The world as we found it is not going to be destroyed. It will be kept. We are the ones who are going to be replaced. That's exactly what we need to understand in our lives. We are the ones going to be replaced when we don't do things well. And so, I should be a responsible somebody and not taking advantage or abusing what God has given me on this earth. No, I must know this, that I am accountable to God and that I will one day be asked what I did with what He gave to me. What I did with the job He gave to me. What I did with the marriage He gave to me. What I did with the religious life He gave to me. What I did with the priesthood He gave to me. What I did with the political responsibility He gave to me. I may not have a very strong opposition in the country where I am as a political leader, and I may be even complacent that no one is questioning me over the work that is entrusted to me. But remember, you are a tenant. No matter what position you hold in society, you are a tenant. You didn't come with anything on this earth. You found everything in place. And know that there is a higher power that you have to be answerable to. And so, be responsible. How are you going to be responsible? Be responsible in the way that the second reading recommends to us. We hear St. Paul saying, finally, brethren, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worth of praise, think about these things. Think about justice. Think about what is honorable. If people call you honorable, be honorable yourself. Respect yourself. Don't go after other people's spouses. Don't go after other people's property. No, be the honorable they call you to be. You may not be a political leader. You are having your own family. You are honorable in your own right. And if you are honorable, be a man or a woman worth of honor. In that way, the vineyard will remain with you as a good tenant. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Sunday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me, and I
your best.